We're here with Sam Crosby in the man cave, and in his own man cave right now. And am I hearing some rain on the tin roof there in Queensland as well? It's nice to hear. Otherwise, somebody's having a very loud shower.
Very perceptive, Paul. Close the window now, though.
I love it. I love the sound. I love it. It's a beautiful sound, the rain in Queensland. So today, interesting things here where there's, pretty obvious that for the energy system to hold up, we're probably going to have to try to hold on to coal as part of it for as long as possible. And isn't it interesting they're starting to notice that the blowing up of everything to make them feel good before you've built the stuff to replace it is like trying to win Bathurst with three wheels.
Good analogy. It's totally absurd. It's a cash merry-go-round now, energy system. The only problem is, of course, unlike the merry-go-round at the local fair, this ride's not free. You've got to pay for it, and you're paying for it in your power bills every quarter. Because, of course, as we just described earlier before the break, a lot of your power bills are going to these green energy subsidies to pay for the various obsessions we have with some types of power production in terms of wind and solar. That's going there. Then that weakens the grid and undermines the profitability of coal-fired power stations, which are meant to run all the time. We need to keep them around for when the wind and solar's not there. So they have to get paid extra now, and that will also be put onto your bill. Now, this is one of the reasons why your bill continues to go up, even though you might read in the paper from time to time that power prices are going down, because over the last year, the wholesale price of power has fallen as gas prices have stabilised and the market's shaken out a little bit. But all these extra payments are now added onto that price.
Yes.
That prop up the coal-fired power stations, that pay people to provide emergency power when we're short quite often now, especially in summer in the depths of winter. And so everybody ends up paying more. And it's at the end of it all, you wonder, why, Paul? Why? We still have the coal-fired power stations running. We only get a little bit of power from renewable energy. We're not changing the temperature of the globe. You're just paying more for it. And a whole lot of spivs in the renewable energy sector are making a lot of money on the back of it. We just got to shut this whole thing down and go back to where we were.
Now, Sam, your choices are that you can continue to debate the bloke who knows everything about it, or we can move on to Donald Trump, which I'm going to make the choice for you. So, latest opinion poll turns around and says that Trump's up by 6. Now, this is a poll that's taken place after the court started, been there for a couple of weeks now. Again, national polls don't mean too much because you've really got to get down into the 7 states that matter, and you've got to have 3 candidates, including RFK, or maybe even a couple of others, to see if a point comes off here and a point comes off there. Howard Stern is where Biden went this weekend as a way to try to get around the gatekeepers. I always think that stuff's smart, but Stern's not what Stern used to be. I think abortion will end up sort of supercharging some moves here. But if Trump's been in court and Trump's the lead story every day and it hasn't been a story of cuddles, it's instead, all the accounting and the rest of it, how's he still up by 6?
You're talking about a turnout question. So Australia's quite easy to poll, right? In Australia, we're looking at, the electoral college, who's turning out to vote. Over there, it's all about who's going to stay home, who's going to be animated to go. And Trump's people, they don't care if they're seeing him on the news at a rally in front of 5,000 people or in a witness box. They think he's completely innocent. He's their guy. It's just reinforcing the narrative, and he's out there talking more and more and more. Look, I think obviously he's got every chance in the world to win on his own right. The Kennedy factor makes it really scary for the Democrats. All they need is for him in a couple of different states, and I saw that I think it was last week he got on the ballot in Michigan. All he needs is in a couple of those states like Michigan to get 3-4% of the vote, which is eminently doable.
Absolutely.
That's going to come 80% from the Democratic ticket. That's a real worry.
Yeah, well, hence why it's really interesting. Trump's been wailing on RFK. They'll no doubt be the same when it comes to the Democrats. But as always, I try to show you the data rather than just, sure, the doddering man's funny to watch, but let's not fall into that trap because, of course, that's where Hillary was in 2016. Democrats were, of course, even with George W. Bush for the best part of 8 years.